How you feeling today? You know, Mayweather said he wants Pacquiao, May 2nd.
They decided yet?
No, but Mayweather said he wants Pacquiao May 2nd.
To do what?
To fight him.
No.
He said he's focused on him. I know you're a big Pacquiao fan.
Yeah.
I like that one, right? What's that?
I hope the fight happens.
What happens?
Mayweather Pacquiao.
In May, if the weather's good.
No! Get out of here. Come on, let's get back to work.
Okay, back to work. Let me. We have Tiger Williams in the house, putting in work, 13-0, 12 knockouts. Close, well, you know, it's in the next fight, 13-0, 12 knockouts, I got it right. Putting in the right work, you have Tugstsogt in the house. Tugstsogt, Olympic winner from... Olympic silver medalist from Mongolia. And now he's training with legendary Hall of Fame trainer, Joe Goossen. Joe, what can you tell us about Tugstsogt?
We just got done. We're wrapping up the workout right now. I can tell you, for a 118 pounder, he is a hard hitting mother. I can tell you.
I thought he was a 140 pounder.
I know, it's crazy, isn't it?
How does he make 118?
You know what? That's the thing. Some guys have these, they look heavier than they are, and then you get guys in the same weight division that are half their size. Well, how? It's just something physiologically, like Molina. How did Molina ever make 130? How did Diego Corrales ever make 130? That was up 6 feet.
How did Tommy Hearns make 47?
Well, because he had nothing. His waist down, he's very skinny. But you're right, from here he was like a cobra. But you know, usually the tall guys that are, you know, upper body heavy have the thinner legs, which is kind of a good thing for a fight. You know, you don't have a lot of weight to carry around.
That's true. But Tugstsogt, just watching him, he has the hand speed, he has the intelligence, he has good movement. Mm-hmm. I'm impressed.
Look, I gotta tell you, sometimes you get guys out of the amateurs and they still fight like amateurs, and then you've gotta spend a year or two to convert them to the pro style. What I love about Tugstsogt is that, or as we call him now, King Tug.
King Tug.
King Tug, that was Molina's moniker for him. So.
But the name came because his ancestry, his grandfather, right?
His father and his grandfather were kings in Mongolia. And you know, he comes from royal blood. And I can tell you, he's got a very warrior spirit about him. Well, we don't know about Genghis Khan, so, you know, that whole
Genghis Khan used to kick ass.
To put it mildly. That being said, you know, he has a real California Mexican pro style already. He's a great body puncher. He's got good head movement. He'll sit right in the pocket with you and not get hit. So he's very adept at that. You know, and that takes a real it takes some real sophistication to be able to do that coming out of the amateurs. It's just not that easily learned. So he's been doing that for a while, obviously. It really fits into my style here.
Tug, how do you like working with Joe? It's a lot of new things you never did back home. A lot of new...
Danny, he's being asked a question.
Go ahead, tell him.
Good. I'm happy.
He's happy, hey. Yeah. Isn't that what we want in life, to be happy?
It is, but it's so much new to learn and he picks up quickly.
I'm telling you, he came in with a nice schematic, a nice blueprint already. The kid's very sophisticated for not having a pro fight yet. Just ask the few guys he sparred with already. They go, man, this guy's a machine. Tim Molina, where's Carlos, my bro? Oh, wait a minute, that's Spanish. I'm sorry.
I'm
going to teach him some Mongolian so he can speak.
Okay, what are you going to teach him in Mongolia? Let's give the basic. How do you say, hello, how are you?
Sanu. Sanu.
Sanu. How do you say knockout?
Knockout.
Kill.
Knockout.
Good night. Joe, is this the first fighter from Mongolia that you're training?
Second. I am one of the rare world champions out of Mongolia, Latka Sim.